The first step to successfully initiating your 2024 consolidated application is ensuring you have access to NexSys. Only level 5 users have the ability to initiate and submit an application, add users to the application. If you do not have access as a level 5 and need it, please visit our MDE website for all NexSys related support materials, including the NexSys security access form, creating a MyLogin account, and the NexSys guide to adding users to an organization or application. Once you've successfully logged into NexSys as a level 5 user, you should see consolidated application under My Opportunities. You will see your district appear and the option to either don't copy forward or copy forward your 2023 consolidated application. If you choose don't copy forward, you will start with a blank application. If you choose to copy forward your 2023 consolidated application, some of the information from 2023 will be carried forward, like grade spans for your buildings, private schools, and other school information. Click Agree and you will enter the 2024 consolidated application. Once you've entered the application, you will make your way down the left sidebar, one screen at a time, in order. Start with Cover Page. You'll want to review the information under Entity to ensure that it is accurate. If it is not accurate, your LEA's details in the Educational Entity Master, or EEM, will need to be updated. Choose your LEA's main and secondary contacts. If you do not see your desired main contact or secondary contact, it needs to be updated. You can do this under the Add, Edit, People screen under Tools, near the bottom of the left sidebar. The first thing you'll see is a list of people that are assigned to your application, along with their assigned role, active dates, and who assigned them. To add a new level 2, 3, or 4 user to your application, click on the plus button and choose Add User from Organization. Enter your organization name and click Search. The list of all registered users will appear. Select the user you wish to add. Choose the administrative level. And enter an active date. You may enter an end date, but you do not need to. Once you are done, click Save. Go back to the cover page. And you will see the newly added users from the drop-down menus. Once you're finished with the cover page, click Save. Next, open the assurances and certifications and important information screens and review them. The screen should automatically save upon opening them. You can tell by looking at the last saved message below the Save button. If that is not there, then this page did not save. Also, if you find that the box on the left sidebar is unchecked, it did not save. Our next screen to complete is the Review Grant Selection screen. Every grant source your LEA is eligible to receive should have an available allocation listed, and an accepted amount should already be entered for you. The accepted amount should always match the allocation available. For those grants you aren't eligible for, click the radio button, Do Not Apply. If there are any grant sources you wish to apply for, but later in the program year, you may choose Apply Later. If you have carryover available, it will show up at this time. Ensure the accepted amounts match the available amounts, just like you did for your new allocations. Please note that anytime you make changes to the screen, other screens further down in the application will be impacted and will require a revisit to potentially update them. After you have completed the screen, you may save and move on. For now, you can skip Add Edit Grant Members. We will revisit the screen later when it is time to add school level budgets and consortium members if you're complete. Similarly, with consortium acceptance, we will skip this and revisit it later. This screen will only be used if you're a member of a consortium like Title III Part A English learners. Next, under Participation of Private Schools, choose the option that reflects private school participation for your district. This screen will only be visible to traditional LEAs that have accepted amounts and grant sources that are subject to equitable services. Traditional LEAs should ensure invitations to participate in federal programs are sent to all private schools that may be serving students who reside within district boundaries. We recommend sending invitations to all private schools within a 25-mile radius of district boundaries, but it is possible students could attend private schools even further away. Additional resources and sample letters for this purpose can be found on our OES website.